that it's not happening, because it's so happening. I gotta set up shots. We gotta do shots. We gotta do shots of awe with Jason Silva, who also has a show called Brain Games. All right, let's do this. We gotta bring in one. Probably should have done all this a long time ago. Not very bright, that Brian Brushwood. Just bright enough to Brian convince Brushwood, people he knows things. Brushwood. WPR, not saying the words because the lyrics are racist. WPR, that was amazing. Okay, hold on. Perfect. Looks great. Good job, gents. So many beers. We're lords of the beers. This is a pray to the bearded one. All right, guys. Here is what's going on. I'm trying to set up shots super fast because we are seconds away from the premiere of the first full season of Hacking the System. It's coming right in your face. I guess soon, and beg of them to do things. Yes, that too. Man, I'm so sorry that I don't already have all this done. There we go. Boom. We'll do that. And then we got one.
Yeah, that feels better.
Is that, Yeah, no, do not fall for the false bearded prophets of merit and, what's going on downstairs? They're just so excited. We can hear the kids downstairs watching the show. Normally, I always have to shut it. A beard one.
The kids are going to watch it and go, oh, it's just dad being dad.
Yeah. All right, guys, welcome to the Hacking the System live stream viewing Woo! Party. I'm Brian Brushwood.
Jason Murphy.
Heck yeah. There you go. Let's get up on there. Yes. Yeah, you keep talking. Let's get a little bit of audio.
How's that?
Bleh. Math science is too tight.
It's tight.
We need to break down that pilot that we did of Encyclopedia Idiotica. I found, like, I saved that footage. It was supposed to be dead and buried in the desert, and I wouldn't let it happen.
I think there's probably something good there.
It's amazing to actually watch. I don't know. We had some ambitious ideas that were just before their time.
Yes.
Nobody understood us, but thankfully, having returned back to whatever,
we found someone who will tolerate us.
That's all that matters, and that's you guys. I'm trying to call Justin Robert Young, but I can't quite find him on air. For those of you guys wondering what's going on, here are the rules. Number one. If you're at a party and someone busts out some weed, go out and smoke your weed, but don't go rubbing it in our face that you got weed on you.
Where did this come from?
Look, I am aware that there are less than legal ways to watch Hacking the System, but I don't want to see it in the chat. And I don't want to hear about
metaphor.
It.
Yes. I get it.
Exactly, right? We are thankful that our friends over at National Geographic Network are allowing us to do these watch parties because it allows us to make it feel like you're right there on the couch sharing in our excitement.
You're right here.
Yeah.
Is there a problem with my mic?
Yes, I have you muted. That would be the problem.
You asshole.
Yeah. That would be the problem with your mic, is that you can't be you can't be heard. Here, let's keep talking, buddy.
All right, how about that?
Hey, man, look at that. Now that
that's
sweet
better.
Baritone is
your
all melted
board
in our face.
Is bigger than mine.
Oh, my gosh, I have so many knobs. I get to tweak so many little nips. Okay, so if things sound good, and by the way, if you want to synchronize up at home, I'm going to play this ad, which I'm certain would not be against the law. So synchronize, pause your DVRs, and get delayed just enough that your audio on this links up.
At the sound of the tone.
On a new episode of Ultimate Survival Alaska.
Weirdly, the main thing I could do is play the commercials.
The bad choice and club sympathy for the competition comes before strategy.
Yeah, I'm just down to a sock right now.
I got an extra set on me.
Right on, dude. Thank you.
Yeah.
We just gave away victory. What else can we give you? Cook some beans and rice.
I don't even know if our team's
going
to make
now?
It. If we
we can talk over it.
So with
cable, set up.
When you have cable, shows just come on whenever the hell they want.
Yeah, no.
And you don't like it's like a push and say you didn't play now. It's like
it happens. I prefer to think of it as you are freed from the burden of having. I get overwhelmed. You know, it's like, you know what I wish is if curators would decide on what content they thought I would really enjoy, set it all up.
The cable companies are burdened with glorious purpose.
Hey, man.
Loki's argument. Right
all I know is that some magic was made possible thanks to our friends over at the National Geographic Network.
Yes.
By the way, we did have a number of people who were annoyed at me because they realized, like, the last day that they couldn't watch it on Canadian television or whatever.
Yeah, we got a lot of international friends, a lot of folks in the UK and all over the place who can't see it. That's a bummer. But now that we have more episodes, perhaps in the near future there will be some sort of purchasable ephemeral or physical
media. Oh my
god,
brains just explode.
Right?
At some point they're going to sell like DVDs and
we're going to go to Half Price Books and there's going to be a Hacking the System section.
That is amazing.
$3.99 blue sticker.
Exactly.
Yeah, you know Tom worked at Half Price Books here in Austin.
It'll be right next to 37 copies of Hitch. And Jerry Maguire.
Club.tv and Brick.
Did you like your time at Half Price Books, Tom?
Yeah, I did. Well, I liked my time in Austin anyway. And they're great people at Half Price Books that I worked with. I made some of my best friends in the world there.
Which Half Price was it?
The one on Guadalupe, 3110 Guadalupe.
It's gone.
They moved up to Lamar, I know, after I left.
Yeah. Yeah, the one on Lamar is like the king. That's the big one.
The one on Lamar, I mean, we were the biggest one when we were on Guadalupe, and they moved to Lamar because they got too big for the Guadalupe location. And the one on Lamar is where I bought the special editions of Star Wars on VHS when they first came out in 1997.
Holy cow, dude. The special editions were – oh, wait. So you're not talking
about
the THX.
Because I bought them at the Albertsons that used to be there.
That's amazing. Welcome to reminiscing about old Austin.
Yeah.
Yes. Everyone can relate, right?
I mean, we've all been there, right?
Yeah.
Come on. Okay, so real quick, hopefully you've synchronized your audio. We're going to, one of the things that we want to do is blow the ever-living hell up out of the hashtag Hacking the System. That's hashtag #HackingTheSystem. And now's the time to go.
Is now the time?
Now's the time, because here's the thing. It, as I understand the Twitter algorithm, it reacts to a burst of activity. So if we were to have a burst of activity right now yeah, right around
everyone
now.
On Twitter,
get her tank.
Hashtag Hacking the System.
Hello.
We did it last time.
We hit national trending status.
National trending status, which pretty much validates us as people.
Wonderful.
In the future, if you don't get trending, the Sandman.
Oh my god! Oh my god! It's an ad! It's an
what?
Ad!
What?
It's an ad!
There are commercials?
It's an ad!
New series next.
That was way too easy. Hacking the System.
Oh,
new
shit!
Series.
That's a commercial.
Oh shit! We're in a
Geographic.
Fucking commercial. That's
what?
Amazing.
It's that kind of thrill. Did you figure out our brain boost? Scientists noticed
that was amazing.
Was there cheering downstairs? A little bit of pee came out. I'm not gonna lie. It's just, yeah. This chair. It's
whoa!
Now I should
drink more water.
I just saw a hashtag hacking The system.
So select few. Assemble.
System.
Hashtag hacking the system on Twitter.
System commercial. Strangely, maybe more excited
than the actual show
for that than the show. Awesome. Holy crap. What a surprise. That was amazing.
I was in a commercial one time.
For those of you guys just joining us, we have all decided to become more merit-like after our time in Los Angeles. Jason and I have grown beards.
Yep.
And both of them got unruly. And we cleaned up for you guys today. We decided we tried to look a little bit.
You're looking sharp.
Pretty for you.
Yeah. I might have to just clean mine up. You guys are putting me to shame.
I kind of
look like you've been living in a dumpster.
It's a long weekend.
You look like a piece of crap, sir.
I wish that we had grown these out like over the course of one episode. Like, we've got an outdoors episode coming up. I wish that we had shot it, been clean shaven like we were in the beginning.
We should have done that episode first and then shot everything in reverse order. So, yes. Like, in 2 days, we're just like, oh, so grizzled.
Exactly. And we should have had a cameo with Tom Merritt as Sasquatch.
Tom Merritt should have been like the crazy old bearded hermit who's just like, you guys don't understand what it takes to hack the wild.
It's like, okay, Brian.
The wild's going to get you.
This hack will protect us from any predators like Dracula, Sasquatches, or Tom Merritt.
And he comes in and goes, that's what you think. And
then he goes, or just feral
gravity.
A feral Tom Merritt has appeared.
That's awesome.
It's super effective.
What's funny is I can't hear what Penny's excitedly shouting downstairs, but it's clear there's just this unbridled excitement. I just hear that. Yeah,
I think it was like,
ooh, a seal, a bird, a penguin.
That dog has a puffy tail. You joining? Okay, if you want to wait. One thing that I put the word out. I honestly don't know if this is going to work out or not, but we invited. I sent out an email to everybody who was working on the show.
Oh yeah.
Oh my gosh, look at this. This is the end thing. Is that everyone's growing a hacking the system beard? We invited the folks who worked on the show to call in on the Skype line. So hopefully we'll get some of them
are even listening. They were probably like, oh, Jesus, that guy again.
Here's
what I know, that if I were editing Hacking the System, I would be sick.
Speaking of which, I think we really tapped onto something, because this was in the original pitch that we had for Hacking the System, was the idea of doing the live second screen experience.
Yes, yes.
And then, Penny's playing brain games is what's happening.
I'm like,
what is she screaming down there?
Banana.
And so at any rate, it was in our original pitch that we wanted to have a second screen experience where you could get kind of a director's commentary, because normally that's a DVD add-on feature, but it's like, well, what if that was just, you know, part of the experience from the beginning? And do you know what I saw on Friday? The Mythbusters did our exact thing. I'm saying this still. And first of all, full disclosure, man, it's complicated. It's complicated having two dads.
Is one of them Greg Evigan and the other one Paul Reiser?
Yes, it's really awkward because, you know, one of them's really uptight and stodgy and the other one's like a loose hippie. And it's
one of them's giving you allowance and the other one is also giving you an allowance.
That's a little bit of what's happening.
What else did we... Promise? No, that's other things that we pitched.
Yeah.
That somehow they decided, Ping Pong, hello Ping Pong, if you're watching, Ping Pong decided, yes, let's buy the show that these ruffians have provided us, but let's not use these goddamn idiotic
ideas. Clearly criminal ideas that we have in there. One of these days, and who knows, maybe there'll be an opportunity. We'd have to get clearance. You know, you're going to hear us play coy because we are very, very aware that the world of the internet operates different from the world of television. And that was something that we learned working on the show was like there are certain things you can't do, like commit crime and just secretly record people and not tell them.
Yeah.
And then
you actually still can't do those on the internet. You're just less likely to get caught.
Yes.
What are you, a lawyer?
Yeah. What are you, a cop?
Yeah. The catchphrase of the summer.
Oh,
what do you
my
got?
Gosh. Oh, yeah, that's right. Is that soy sauce? All right, we're seconds away here. I'm gonna. If you want to synchronize your audio.
Sometimes it feels like the gulf between our two brains.
It's not Brian Games. I thought they rebranded.
I got really excited for a second there. That was amazing.
I was like, you mean your hit lead in?
All right, hold on. We got a caller on the line. Hey, what's up, caller?
Hey, Brian. First of all, I want to say happy birthday. Second of all, I want to say congrats to you and Ryan. And I hope all goes well. I'm really looking forward to this. Love you both. Dying of fire.
Dude, thank you. And look, they're even playing the lullaby for us. That's fantastic. Thanks, man. Joining us on the line is Justin Robert Young. Are you there, buddy? I'm sure he's about to start talking any minute. Right about there, you're on screen. Now you're out
there
of
you
screen.
Go.
There you go. Everything's fine here. We're all fine. How are you?
How are you?
Yeah. Oh, wait. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Every 45 seconds. Bonnie, did you see the ad? To help make your car harder
to steal. Presented by Farmers. It's a commercial. Smarter at farmers.com.
The following program
contains secret hacks. Attempting some of these shortcuts can be dangerous and is ill-advised.
How many times do you have to say that?
Oh, by the way, here's your favorite game, is see how many Diamond Club references I was able to sneak in to the show. hold on, we're about to bring Justin on in just a moment.
Right, man.
Buddy, downstairs I hear Penny go, "You're being kidnapped on TV!" This may be my favorite experience of my entire life. Just
Ryan and zip ties. Boy, if I had a nickel. It's actually, they're taking him directly to the leather bar.
It's a suspiciously empty van.
It's almost as though we didn't actually have kidnappers kidnap me.
This was their first stop.
They were making the rounds.
That thing gets dick to butt with jackass magicians. At the end of the episode.
I'm Brian Brushwood. I love that moment.
Like you're the Wolverine.
And then stab folks at home.
Oh, slow-mo box delivery.
Not your best look,
that's
Brian.
That's what she said. Not your best. Who said that?
My mother-in-law. It was her one comment that she said out loud. Yeah, she
was. You in the UPS?
She was. Well, yeah, and she was so proud of the entire thing, and she gets there. She's and the moment she said that, I was like, not your best look, Brian.
Hey, there's the guy we were spying on.
Yeah. Hold on. Let me.
Mitch.
Yes. Let me hang on 1 second. I'm gonna bring in Justin Robert Young here. Do a little desktop pro. Move this down. Yeah. Wait here. We'll do this.
Put him right there.
How about that? We'll cover up Jason Murphy and get to two top merits.
Two men. What's one too many? Maybe two.
Let me see if I can crop this correctly, and then I'll save it, and then I think we'll be set.
This is like watching a vacation video. It's like, oh, summer.
It really is. It's that's one of the weird.
I don't know who that is.
That's an old ThinkPad.
What an asshole pitch.
Hey, Steph.
1094. Hold on, Justin. Keep talking, buddy.
I just want to point out that Mitch is a real dickhead.
Okay. All right.
Thanks, Justin. he deserved this.
We justify our torture. Okay, I'm almost there. I'm sorry that I didn't have all this done.
Just a few more seconds.
Almost there.
Look at this, walking like the right stuff down the sidewalk, looking like badasses.
I'll tell you what, man. It was kind of a lot of fun.
Hey, a nice blue flower. Can I just come in? I'm here to replace the pressure roller on the copier. Oh, okay.
Are you new? So this was one of the one of our favorite surprise ideas was when like apparently. in this case, we're setting it up as we're stealing a single hard drive. But the way the real criminals do it is that they go to auctions, like especially federal or government auctions, where they're selling off all of the copiers, and they'll just blow, you know, drop 10 grand, get 800 of them, and then just throw them away and take the data out.
What you're looking for. Oh,
you're doing it
hard. Fake ID magic. This is rad.
Yeah, this was also a cool challenge of by the way, Dharma Club, Dharma Club. That what originally was, you know, there are certain things you have to do, like hide logos, and so we hid the logos on the laptop, so I used it as an excuse to cover it with inside references.
Copy, doctor.
Release from the receptionist.
Wait, I'm sorry. I'm saving this right now. Stop talking. I mean, go talk now.
What? I don't understand.
Sorry.
So much pressure.
I finally got Justin in on the line, and I was trying to juggle everything.
Yeah, here, you guys, why don't you guys provide commentary during the show and then just bring us on as like panelists during the commercials?
Yeah.
Cuz you guys have the actual funny stuff and interesting things to say.
Do you still have your copy doctor's outfit?
I do. As a matter of fact,
I don't.
Wait, you don't?
No.
What? I totally saw. I do have your hat.
You do?
Hold on. Yes.
All right.
Bonnie, can you go get the
copy doctor?
that was our favorite thing. Is having our own business. The copy doctors who didn't go to copy medical school.
Like, copy. Yeah, we didn't go to copy medical school. We were a lot like. Kind of. It really reminded me of like. This is what it's like if I was Jason Bourne.
You would imagine. Well, because
it was
you just
very similar.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you just
we
adopt
use a lot
personal
of the same skills.
Well, except for any of the talented parts.
What? No.
And hey, there we go.
When we, I don't think he's gonna make it into the episode. But that security guard caught us, and you put your thumb through his eye. That was awesome.
I stole his space pen and just kept jabbing him in the throat.
Say, is this your pen? Is this like De Niro? So this is a real thing, as all of the things in the show are.
Oh yeah, no, we should point this out. Is this is one thing that that National Geographic is absolutely fastidious about? Is that every single thing had to be factually accurate, which means if you're super careful, you can hear some I don't know how to phrase it. We the amount of research that went into this is extraordinary, and there were. Some stuff that had to get cut because we didn't have the sources to back it up 100%, you know? And so what I'm hoping...
Where we figured, you know, this is probably legit, and we found some sources, but we couldn't... Everything has to be, like, double-sourced, right?
Yes.
Before it makes
yes,
it on the air.
Correct, correct.
Was it double? Yeah, I think it was double.
No. They take that stuff very seriously.
They kept us honest, really. Cars don't... Cars, when you saw them moving quickly a second ago?
That's not actually how fast they go.
Well, this is... in Los Angeles, it is. Because everyone in Los Angeles is driving like they really want to murder you.
I should post those selfies that we took right here.
Oh, yeah!
Alright, hold on.
This is going to go down. This right here, it's going to be like the last episode of MASH. It's going to be that big. With us looking into the... Copy doctor!
That's for the rest of the... Is that your shirt? Okay. No, then I don't know whose that is. We got somebody's random shirt.
I like it. It's not mine.
Dude, look how excited. No, just...
Thank you, Bonnie. This is Brian's.
Oh, it's...
It's not big enough for my head.
I think they were both the same. They're the same hat. Here, you can just...
There we go.
Let me see.
Oh, Mitch, you poor bastard.
Quick
quiz. Which state
has the most car thefts in the U.S.? Quick, say your vote in the chat.
California or Michigan? It's not one of the choices.
Anytime you guys see a quiz, go ahead and throw it in the
Ukraine.
In the chat.
Is home to 8 of the top 10 cities for stolen vehicles. Yeah, when we were there, am I right? Damn.
That
the copy doctor's in that state. Drive. Lock up your daughters. I don't know.
What? Like, I don't know. It's hard to keep everything alive and give infra...
You can recover quite a bit.
Like what?
Like this.
Yeah.
And
All right, here we go. Okay, so here, we'll
I don't remember shooting this at all.
Yeah, you don't remember when we got married and you were a female and I was all doughy-eyed staring at you?
We did get married.
Oh, my God, can we talk about that? We'll talk about that during the show.
Well, common law.
Yeah. We lived like we're married. Thanks for calling
you
in,
You introduced yourselves as being married, so...
Hey, by the way, what's the are we pushing a hashtag? What are we doing?
Hashtag hacking the system. I'm about to tweet out one of the selfies that we took from the that moment.
Yeah. Go cry havoc and let's slip the dogs of war.
Let's slip the dogs of hashtag hacking the system.
Yes.
Man, I took a lot of selfies. Okay, you want to know the one part that really broke my heart and made me sad was. I didn't know if I was able to say what we were up to and what we were doing.
Oh, yeah.
And so we just called it being on vacation
yeah.
Right? And here we go.
Why are Jason and Brian vacationing for 3 months in Los Angeles?
Well, this is the part. Like, I thought everybody would see right through the ruse.
Yeah.
But then, like, I talked to people I've known for years. They're like, hey, man, what are you up to? I hear you're on vacation. I see a lot of tweets and pictures of you on vacation.
Yeah.
Listen, there's a lot to life, Brian. There's people deal with a lot of stuff, you know. If you just straight out lie to them, no matter how easily it should be found out, there is going to be a segment of the population that will just believe you.
Yes.
Time out. No one will believe anything that the Taliban here says.
Oh, yeah.
Because reasonable beard.
Because I have a beard.
Reasonable
right?
beard.
Dude, yeah.
This sounds
like a beard envy in the baddest way.
Look at him drinking his communist wine. Hate drama, go to cars.com. Look at that. What is this? Drink beer.
So one of the weirdest
like a man
As you can imagine, like they have a budget for travel to put us up when we're out there, and we realize originally it's like, well, you could have a hotel room and I could have a hotel room and we could be in a hotel for 4 months.
Yeah, that's lonely.
Or
I've
what
seen
if,
Lost in Translation.
What? Yeah. The shoot ends with me whispering something mysterious to you, and then
that's in episode 10. Don't spoil it.
And but we realized that it would work out much better if we got like a condo or something from Airbnb. Yeah. And we ended up with this rad place like only a mile or less than a mile from the beach.
You got the third degree.
On what?
Remember? Well, this isn't a vacation.
Oh, because you guys weren't like so much allowed to be doing what you were allowed to be doing, right?
Yeah. Well, it turns out that the person that we rented the place from was not so much supposed to be renting it as a vacation home.
Yeah.
And so he waits until the day we move in. He's like,
don't tell anybody.
He's like, by the way, if anyone asks, just say you moved in forever and that you live there now.
Yeah. And we were like, bye. Okay. And sure enough, like 2 days later. I'm there, like, in my stormtrooper robe.
Yes.
And I hear Brian getting the third degree from someone who's just like, well, this isn't a vacation home. I can hear Brian's patience cracking.
Well, and I was like, well, good. Thankfully, we're not on vacation.
Well, also, I mean, like there is a point in which, like, this was a taxing project for you, Brian. Like your grip on sanity waxed and waned throughout this summer.
That's,
you know,
very so, true.
Well, in play, yeah. Well, because keep in mind also, it's like this was the same year we took Cord Killers independent. We took Night Attack independent. So it's like in any other year, I would have been just like, you know. Oh, here, if you want to see.
Oh, that was a butt.
Let's just say you should keep all your body parts off the company copier. Look, we're only interested in Mitch, so I'm going to destroy all these. We'll,
you know, I wonder if it almost made it worse, the fact that it was obscured. Like, if people wouldn't just think it's something worse than a butt. Keep all your body parts off. But at any rate, so it wasn't like I could just take it easy and drop off the radar, like, have someone else fill in for me for a while, because it was important that we get those other properties on the ground, off the ground. And so it was just an astonishing. I mean, you guys were both cool enough to change the days that we recorded for all that stuff, but it ended up being real busy.
This particular episode, I think, is just so funny. Also, for anybody who hasn't connected the dots, you came to Dragon Con in costume.
Yeah, dressed as all the characters that did not exist on television yet. So,
people can post pictures in the chat from Dragon Con. There is quite a lot of Copy Doctor running around the Atlanta Hilton and Marriott floor.
This was right now, this destroying documents by throwing it in the water. Some of these we understood and we knew they worked because of the double fact finding research and so on. But some of them we were trying out for the very first time. That one destroying documents, we're like, well, how long is it going to take for them to dissolve? We're like, well, I don't know. And so we did it, and it was literally in 10 seconds. It was totally gone.
And I felt bad because I kept like getting the thing too close to the surface of the water.
You kept
like
splashing bleach water all over me. Yeah.
And does that just speed up the process, or do you need to like mix it up like that?
Well, bleach just, I mean, you know, that's a good question. We only tried it the one way because the whole point was to make it as thorough as possible.
Fast and thorough, yeah.
This one surprised me. The whole quiz thing, John was the one, my assistant John, pointed out that what's great about the quizzes is that you're essentially playing the game Wits and Wagers every few minutes. And so, you know, it's like, well, how much does this thing cost? I'm like, I don't know, anywhere from a dollar to all of them. Man, that's a sweet-ass lens you got.
Yeah.
That's the nice thing when it comes to taking these photos. It's like the director of photography is able to just hand over this amazing freaking bajillion-dollar thing. It's like, yeah!
Please don't drop
nice
it.
Nice ear shot.
If you want to play a little game, and anyone who's watched Night Attack knows that I have a problem just grinning like an idiot at all times. And I realized that I'm supposed to look like an expert on this show, so I slowly learned to perfect the casual scowl at all times.
Man, I want to see by the end of this season, I want to see two supercuts, just a nonstop scowl from Brian, just editing all the scowls together, and also all of Jason's questions.
How does that work, Brian?
Yeah.
Oh, but
it's funny because the rules are like just different on television. If this was if these were individual YouTube videos, we could get in 45 seconds, go straight to it, and get out. But on television, the rules are different. You have to plan on the fact that people are coming back from getting popcorn over the break, so you need to reset up stuff.
It is the necessary. I mean, like to say that Jason will ask a lot of questions on this series is to say that a point guard will pass the basketball a lot. Like,
yes,
it's the nature of the role. Like, you just need to do it to move things along.
What I like is and this is a great idea. If you want to put a low cost GPS tracker, just take an old mobile device, keep it plugged in and charged, and you track it like your iPhone or your iPad. What's funny is as you see me zoom in, you're like, see. And I'm like, and that's close enough. You know, I live in Austin. That's all you need to see. By the way, huge shout out to the amazing Darren Kitchen, host of Hack 5. This is his legit jam, man.
He helped us out on the first
pineapple.
Two.
Pineapple. You just saw the pineapple, right? This device is called a Wi-Fi pineapple. Yeah. And
by the way, everybody hit up Hack 5 Darren and Snubs right now to let them know that their pineapple just got FaceTime on national television.
Yeah.
And also, keep tweeting #hacking the #hackingthesystem.
Hacking the system.
Like a lot. Like, fun really fact, annoy your friends.
That.
And followers.
Wi-Fi pineapple is available from...
Remember how hot it was?
Hackshop.com. Okay, for the record, there are two things I will remember about that summer forever. One is being married to Jason Murphy for a quarter year, and the other is sweating constantly because it's like you can't have AC on because it makes too much noise.
Oh my god, that warehouse. The workshop.
Like, Jonesy was, was so patient, but he's like, and
our sound guy.
Yeah, we would get ready to go, and we were like, can you hear that AC? And then there's that like half second pause as he's like really wants to lie and just goes, no. Yeah.
AC up. Or we would have them, we would be mic'd up and we'd be in the workshop, and he's like, wait, I can't hear it. But we had sweat so much that the mic tape
had fallen off. Fallen out. It was dangling down below. Yeah. Victim of fraud the second you insert your card. This one was an interesting thing because it's a the segment is basically just us explaining how a skimmer works. Oh my God. Need to grab some cash.
Which one of these do you use? Yeah, by the way, a picture of Curtis LaRock and the copy doctor from Dragon.
That's nice. Amazing.
I don't know which one of those looks more insane.
Yeah. Oh, dude. Curtis LaRock has, you can't see it right now, he has majestic hair that goes all the way down to his belt line. It's amazing.
Is he in the same terrorist cell as
yes. Apparently, beards are the in thing for the whole world. That's an ATM skimmer. So, this whole ATM skimmer is astonishingly prevalent. And what's amazing is, you know, we just wanted to do a quick alert thing. And, you know, in an ideal world, we would have, you know, gone out and actually stolen someone's ID and then chased them home and all that stuff. But for a segment that's really us talking at posters, there's so much good energy, and it came out really well. I was really excited about it.
Yeah, and when we shot this, a bunch of the people on our crew were talking about how it had happened to them or how they had been bumped, which is something we didn't cover.
Oh, that's right. I guess also there when this came out on the online stuff, and this is another thing I like that Nat Geo's doing is they're putting all the online segments on there, especially on the YouTube channel. People were pointing out that it happens at a lot of look at that Merit Militia man! I had gotten that just like days before from you, Tom.
That's awesome.
But they were saying that it happens at a lot of gas stations as well.
I always shake the gas station thing because, I've actually spotted them at gas stations before.
Really?
Yeah. Darren Kitchen just tweeted, based on the tweets, I'd guess the Wi-Fi pineapple was just shown on Hacking the System.
Well, thanks for watching, Darren.
yeah, that's he's hacking. To be fair, I'm actually just going by your reactions because on Comcast, it is not on until 10 o'clock Pacific.
Oh, because you can't get you can't get the West Coast feed.
This is only for Central.
Planet of the Gandalfs?
Yeah. By the way, Darren Kitchen has already paid his dues, man. That dude has made possible some amazing inside sauce hacks. He's the real deal and my spirit animal. For sure. Yeah. No, he's I play Darren Kitchen on Hacking the System. He's actually Darren Kitchen.
He is an actual copy doctor.
Yeah. Yes.
I play Chewbacca.
He has a doctorate.
Somebody says, I sell snake oil pretty much. I'll say accurate. There we go. I'll tell you what, this is the other thing, too, is each one of these segments, it would take days to get through, you stagger all the different episodes, right? Some episodes would take, like, 3 days worth of stuff, and there would be shots that we would have to, you know, it's probably no big surprise that when we're walking in slow motion, there's a lot of us walking forward, and then turning around, running back, and then walking forward again, you know, so that we could get it looking exactly just right. But it's astonishing to see the time condensing that happens, because when you're doing it, you're just like, man, this is a show about two guys who walk.
Yeah.
and then when it all blends together, it's pretty rad.
So it was like a week per episode, right? That's about right.
Yeah. Well, certainly because a lot of them we had to go back and do extra segments in some cases. I'll tell you what I can't wait for, and I bet this will happen, is there's a lot of segments that will probably show up in the in web content or bonus features on DVDs or whatever. Because I could think of, I don't want to say what it was, but there was one rather high intensity morning we spent. I don't know how to play coy on it.
Where the guy nearly died.
About a future episode?
Yeah. No, not that. I'm talking about a different day.
That was the high intensity morning. Period. There were no others.
I'm talking about where I almost died. And got danger. Oh man, you don't remember that?
Were
morning.
You almost died?
Well, I mean.
Oh, was that when you got so drunk at Venice Beach that you crashed your bike three times?
No. Okay. Yeah. Well, that. All right. That. It was night, and there was a lot of bumps.
It was so was very dark.
And it was hot and I was hungry.
Jason was home playing Diablo.
Yeah.
Didn't have a DD.
Palsy dogs in the house.
Palsy dogs.
Oh, Big Jim in the chat says I had a night attack. That's close enough. Yeah, that's pretty amazing.
So I don't remember what you're talking about.
There was a whole life-saving segment with fire. There was fire involved and a way to extinguish fire.
Oh!
That was...
I know what he's talking about.
I kind of do, too, I think.
You got to realize that when Brian's, like, redoing his stand-ups for the millionth time, this is Jason.
Jason. Yeah.
For days at a time. Yeah.
It's like, oh, Brian's eating fire again.
Yeah.
I'm going to check Twitter.
But that's what was amazing you were basically, we were joking about how you were pretty much Chewbacca. You know, you were there for me, man. That's all that mattered. Hey.
Salute,
and now look
sir.
At us. We have a commercial. Well,
awesome.
Along with the actual show.
Play the commercial
yeah.
again.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. There it is.
Job interview.
We're promoting the next episode.
Save thousands on your next purchase. That was way too easy. Hacking the System. Another new episode next on National Geographic.
Yeah. Oh, I wish you could see. Bitch. Like, I'm looking at Bonnie over there watching the commercials. And I'm like, I'm so getting laid tonight.
I got enough information. I was looking at Brian thinking, I'm so getting laid.
Now, I'm going to expose his weaknesses at home.
Yeah, I was surprised.
Dumpster diving.
Why was the city? Never mind. I guess you have to blur that logo. It's a private company. It's interesting.
Yeah, well,
the trash company.
Well, and you there you go. Like you can see that's a Vaughn's logo that got blurred out. I assume one would think. I guess
what one might reasonably guess
that in California there's a popular grocery store chain.
Hey, remember when you got hepatitis from this scene?
This just in from a friend of the show. Hang on, I got a couple of texts here. Paul Cohorst writes, behind the scenes, it's 120 effing degrees in the workshop. Accurate. Andrew Bates says, right now, across the nation, millions of women are looking at you and fantasizing about you fixing stuff around their house. See, this is a good wits and wagers moment because it's like, I just, you know, any one of those numbers would have been believable to me.
Paul Cohorst, one of our producers who wrote much of what you see here today, and he was actually...
He's one of the big fact checkers, you know.
Yeah,
this
and
is,
he was the guy on set this day. He actually gave me that hoodie.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Started screaming wake up baby in the middle of the night. This is this was definitely something that like the RF broadcasting things. This is great. On Twitter, LN says, well, if I wasn't a paranoid neurotic person who didn't trust the world before, at Schwood just pushed me over the edge by not using an RF based camera. You're going to connect the camera to the... So the RF ones are the ones that just broadcast out and unencrypted.
Yeah. I mean,
like a television one.
The Wi-Fi ones can be compromised as well, but it's a completely different method.
But you can at least put a freaking password on it.
Right. Strangers you need to worry about. We've all had our share of creepy coworkers. It was so hot in that warehouse.
Yeah. So this is one of the things that we were talking about adding to scamstuff.com is the print powder and UV stuff.
Oh yeah.
Because I'm shocked at how well that works and how powerful it really pops when you throw a little. We put it on a little thick for television. I don't know that that's the most subtle way for you to throw that. Hopefully by then you can find out who the bad guy
is. Here, heck away, yeah. Sir. Be careful, though.
Oh, this was...
Because you might see something you don't want to see on someone's keyboard.
I was making... Oh, unfortunately, it got cut, but I was making jokes about how I shuddered to think of what sites you were visiting on the internet. Or, you know, we were making some big...
Yeah. Yeah, that's just the powder, nothing else. Nothing. Oh, okay, Rage Select fans, pay attention for this part.
Oh, yeah. Here, we'll give them a little audio. From an old disposable camera. Jason, you ready to do this? By the way, the disposable camera thing is, if you haven't figured out, you just hook it up to the capacitor. You charge the capacitor, right, and it just, the moment it arcs on your finger.
Ding dong. It was very simple, but yeah.
So, as you can imagine, for close-ups and for slow motions, we had to grab and electrocute ourselves so many times for that.
Yeah.
By the way, Diamond in the background. Diamond in the background. I don't know if you guys see it. There it is.
By the way, Brian, I'm not sure if you can see, just like I'm just having pop up in my activity feed all the pictures from Dragon Con of you as the copy doctor.
Oh, that's amazing.
That's such a happy copy doctor.
It's a dossier
of all our greatest hits. We got him at the cleaners. That's awesome. And here's the kind of the post-mortem of all the ways we got Mitch. Basically everything.
To be fair, Mitch is literal Hitler.
Oh my God! Look, they added extra facts from Farmers Insurance. I didn't know they were doing that. That's smart.
It took me a second. I thought you were serious. I was like, that's an advertisement.
Yeah, it is. It is. It's smart.
Oh my God.
Mitch now lives in a mountain.
Yeah,
on a mountain in Montana now.
He
lives off the land. And does
he's
not have
off, yeah, off the grid. He's got a giant beard. He's got a beard to put all of ours to shame.
He was later nominated for an Oscar for his role as Martin Luther King.
Oh,
look, we made two of these.
Okay, more diamonds. By the way, Captain Monk has a good question that I'll answer in a second. But this was a pretty good setup at the beginning.
When this was done, you looked like you had gone aboriginal, geez. And you hopped back into the car, and I was like, what the hell happened?
Okay, I'm gonna tweet out that photo, too, then.
The other shoe's about to drop. Hang on. And there you go. We were up in this area. Okay.
First of all, those are my two biggest fans. Sorry. Right. Second of all, I lost my wallet in the desert.
Oh, that's right.
Among other things, and there was a magic trick where I turned five ones into five 100s. Spoiler alert: it takes six $100 bills in order to do the trick, and so all of that was in there gone. I was like, son of a bitch.
And we had a PA, Max, who actually went back to look for it.
He drove 35 minutes back. Oh, and this also, it's so hard to speak off the cuff, make everything natural, and get everything factually accurate. And you'll notice that this is almost all one shot. They cut to this for this other stuff, but we shot it all as one shot. And it's like, man, actors have it hard. That's hard to do, is to make it sound good.
You don't understand Brian's trials and travails.
Yeah.
But yeah, during the whole fan thing, all I could think was, oh, this is like the northern area of Grand Theft Auto 5.
Oh, dude, that was the craziest thing. Yeah. We landed and we drove around and we just were in Grand Theft Auto 5. And what's amazing is there was just enough like pollution in the dusk where I was like, you know, it looked like that volumetric fog to make it look like
the draw distance. That's what that is.
It was yes, exactly.
When we were up there shooting the whole emergency thing up in like Palmdale and Lancaster, I was like, Trevor's up here somewhere.
Yes, yes. By the way, the question we got was, which was worse, the camera taser or the doorknob thing? The camera taser was much worse.
Camera taser was way worse.
Because you'll notice that part of the reason it looked so good when we grabbed the handle was that some of the spark arced from the wire onto the metal knob, which meant it wasn't going through our flesh. Whereas the taser, 100% through those prongs.
And we would have like little burn marks on our arms. Speaking of which,
if you've been hit with a tornado, this is probably one of my favorite ones of this, is figuring out how to keep video, or I'm sorry, keep light for the entire night.
Oh,
and by the way, huge shout out to Doug Cheney, director of photography. I mean, that looks beautiful.
Yeah, that looks really good. I wasn't here for most of this.
Oh, that's right.
It was all just you doing this.
Yeah, you're like, stuff. Yeah, hey, you want to come and just watch me walk around?
I wish I had been able to show up, like, as a Ravager, like someone wearing, like, cobbled together, like, armor from a sporting goods store.
Who's the bad guy from the Road Warrior?
Oh, the Humongous.
Yeah, yes.
Just walk away, Brian. Just smash it through the window and, like, I'm here for your women and your gasoline.
Refining they are, ka-chunka-chunka.
And Brian says, Jason? Like, so I didn't sell it. I'm just kind of a thing.
For the record, that did smell like ass.
What, the sardines?
Sardine oil filled the entire house, for sure.
Don't get them packed in water, huh?
Yeah, somebody buys the wrong ones. It was like, Brushwood's a liar, man. Sardines don't power anything. Power LEDs. Fire is an invaluable in an emergency. This is one of my favorite of the online clips that they did. It visually looks so freaking good. You might have a method in your pocket right now. Your cell
phone battery. The picture's great.
Tweeted.
Should give you a spark.
If your cell phone doesn't have a removable battery, check your junk drawer. You might have a. You use an iPhone, which will work
even better. Yeah. That is so astonishingly easy. Like when we first read about this, it's like, what, you just touch it, and then you do it, and you're like, ah. Oh, when we recorded test footage.
Yeah.
After I almost broke my ankle.
Oh, that's right.
I hobbled over on crutches. And then stood still, and then casually was like, "Hey, Jason, do you know you could do this?" Do. Safely contain that fire to keep warm. In this case, we got a couple of paint cans. Make sure one is small enough to fit inside the other. I had seen. What's funny is I remembered a variation of this from Boy Scouts, where you took a paint can and you impaled it like on a stick or a hoe or something up on top, and you were able to use it as a torch. For light, you would have to use gasoline instead of rubbing alcohol, because rubbing alcohol does, you can see it's a really blue flame, but gasoline would burn real smoky and yellow. But it's like, look how fast that absorbs in there.
Whenever I have toilet paper on the end of a stick, I use it for something totally different. Exactly a bonfire. It's portable. It'll keep. Oop, that's correct. That's one of the questions later. Make sure you don't leave
it unsupervised. Actually, there is a butt clenching moment.
Hey, riddle.
I get to non.
We do have some butt humor in the series later. That's the hacking the prison episode when you're trying.
All right.
I was gonna say smuggling stuff. You're the one that went to rape.
Awesome, I've had a bunch of people ask how I got an Apple Watch, and that is my Tokyo Flash Kisei watch, which is awesome because it's got this maze design that kind of obscures the actual time. So as a result, we didn't have to worry about any continuity things. Brady got to pick up shots or whatever. By the rule of three,
after 3 days without water, do we want to talk about the complaints when we were shooting this? Just
became my wait, which complaints? Wait, from
in
me?
In the neighborhood.
Oh, no.
Okay. We'll stay away from
I mean, that. There weren't complaints. There was complaints about previous people who had shot in the neighborhood, and they were worried about what we were doing. By the way, the entire chat room is shouting that I should drink my pee.
I was thinking the same thing. Was there a reason you didn't?
Well, because it's not time for the commercial break yet.
Episode's not over yet. During the commercial break, stay tuned. If we get trending, Brian will drink my urine.
Oh, jeez.
10,000 retweets and Brian drinks his own pee.
This was one that really... I don't know why I never thought about it. You're sitting on... I always thought in a disaster, like, I knew I could fill a bathtub, or I knew... Like, we have a hot tub, and it's like, you can drink that chlorinated water. It tastes terrible, but it's not going to kill you. So it's like, I always figured, like, well, in a disaster, that's where we would get our water, and we'd cook ramen that tastes like chlorine. But the idea of getting, you know, crisp, clean city water or whatever out of your hot water heater was a surprise to me.
water is scarce and you're in an extreme emergency, can you and should you drink
nice.
Your urine?
Here it is.
What?
When water is scarce,
is Penny downstairs watching this still?
Because I have one of those wall
you just messed up your kid
like you
life.
Showed right before that tease.
I'm just expecting her to shout like, "You're drinking your pee on TV, Dad!"
It's the mean guy from Whiplash.
Yeah, seriously. Hey, by the way, I just started remembering that time I saw this episode.
Oh. What's up?
It's Sunday.
Apples are good. Why are you asking if the Super Bowl is tonight, Bonnie?
Because she's like, why am I wasting my time sitting up here with you, jackasses?
When there could I could be watching a Super Bowl, any yeah. Super Bowl.
Have they already determined who's going to the Super Bowl?
Oh, yeah, they determine that years in advance.
I know a little bit about it.
It's like the astrological charts. This year, it's the pig versus the snake.
Neil Caldwell says, gotta say, really expected Schwood to drink that toilet water. Spoiler alert, I did. And for whatever reason, they didn't bother me. I drank toilet water for nothing, apparently.
I came in one day, because I wasn't needed during most of this, and I came in and... Should I save the story till the actual scene?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Hey. Oh, hey.
This is like you just showed up at that moment? Wait, what do you mean?
You had your head buried in a toilet, and I walked into the house, and I was like, hey, guys, what's going on over there? What's up? Hey, Brian. Brian pulls his head out of the toilet. Hey, what's up? Like, all right.
Yeah. I mean, people are saying I drank toilet water for nothing. I would say it was for nothing. I mean, drinking toilet water is its own
drank
reward.
Toilet water to be on TV. Yeah.
The only difference is that I wasn't competing for a $1 million prize on an island somewhere.
It was
Bill Gates.
That's Satan's. Satan's a fan of hacking the system.
Tom had Taco Bell.
Let's see. People are... Man, I just want to say thanks to the folks who are actually sitting, listening just to us watching because they don't have cable or it's not on in their country or whatever. That's freaking amazing.
Yeah, and by the way... Just because Brian will say it a million times, so I'll say it this once. No idea when it's going to come online. He has no idea when it's going to show up in your country. It will be there as soon as it's able.
However, I've switched now to where I want to be like, remember how MTV like had an active trolling campaign where they would advertise to presumably people who already had MTV, where they're like, what's up, jerk? Don't have MTV? Hassle your cable provider.
Yeah.
It's like, so, I looking back on it, that was a weird ass thing for them to do.
Because they figured your friends would be over at somebody else's house.
Yeah, and they just wanted to tease
you,
I guess. Oh, wait. Look, they're advertising hard cider after I drink my pee.
Well, poorly timed there, Wazzer.
No, awesome time. There you go.
Also, wait, this ad where you drink some champagne now looks questionable.
Awesome. Save thousands on your next purchase. That was way too easy. Hacking the System. New episodes Mondays at 10 on National Geographic.
By the way, the new slogan for Strongbow is better than Schwood Pit.
Should you drink your own urine? The answer is yes and no. If you're truly desperate, it'll buy
this
you
is such
a
dicey
two,
one, right?
Yeah.
Because it's like technically we can't encourage people to induce renal failure, but also we can't encourage people to not drink water, to not have a hydration in an emergency.
Lucky for me, they had some apple juice.
Oh, Schwood.
Yeah. Oh, hacking the audience.
You.
Unlucky for me, I pee apple juice.
Which to throw out and which can be repurposed for extended storage. Might be hard cider. Bam.
Hilarious.
Save your food for spoiling.
Lucky
eat
for
it.
Me,
oh.
They had some Strongbow hard cider.
Let's not talk about the fine advertisers that make the show possible.
I'm Strongbow right now. It's the best thing I ever had. Strongbow. For a day or two. And get this. Strong your bow, son.
You that's the slogan.
Yeah.
Strong your bow.
All right. Delicious. What's a wager's time? What's your guess on this one? 9 weeks, 19 weeks, or 9 months for how long these dudes survived at sea? The answer is no guess?
50 years.
5,000 miles surviving on raw fish, sea turtles, and rainwater.
They ate turtles? Those bastards.
Dude, there used to be... do you realize that it took, like... what's the stat where it's like they never had a sea turtle in the British Museum because none of them made the journey back because they were so tasty? They would... when they would go out on the Beagle or whatever, they would take sea turtles. They were super easy to catch. They would flip them on their backs and stack them on top of each other so they would stay there alive, so they'd stay fresh and preserved.
Oh, that's horrible.
And then they'd gobble them on the way back. And so none of them, they were too tasty.
Turtles all the way back.
Turtles all the way down. I've heard this called a hobo stove. This was a fun one because this was one of those times where it's like you see a thing and you learn how to do it, and you're like, yeah, that seems like I can make that for the first time live on camera. And then you start going, you're like, oh, wait, I'm on camera, and I have to make this.
Yeah.
And then luckily it worked out really well. And there's this terrifying moment when we light it, and part of the reason you have the vents is so that you get the dispersed flame like you get from your gas grill at home. But at first it wasn't doing it. I was like, please go look pretty. And then it totally did.
You had some time as a hobo.
That's
when
right.
You went off the grid.
This is where I grew this bit. As a matter of fact, yeah. if you look for a hashtag off the grid, you'll find.
All the hobo catered parties have these eating the dishes. Yeah, it's
just starting to reach. So what happens is this heats up everything, and it eventually... even came out with a more consistent flame. It stopped really coming out the top, but came out through the sides, which was really cool. But in the next 2 hours, this won't guarantee your food safety, but it will help
reduce the risk. CYA.
Yeah. Man, this was one of. This is gonna sound dumb as hell, but. This was actually one of the scariest shoots for me, because in order to shoot this, we had to actually heat wax crayons up to a boiling hot temperature, and then I had to splash it around. And there was one brief moment when I splashed it and I got it on my chest, and luckily it didn't land on my arm or whatever, but like that would have been bad.
That just sounds like a sexy good time to me.
Yeah, or a spa.
Or a spa. Is it 3,600 years, 103
years, or 13 years? Let's do this. 3,600 years.
Yeah, I don't want to eat that cheese.
Yeah, that's gross, man. Get that out of my face.
Yeah, man. I don't want to judge mummies, but y'all eat some gross old cheese, mummies.
Yeah, mummies be gross. You ever seen a mummy like, hey, give me some 3,000-year-old cheese? Get out of here.
I'll just have some Kraft slices. I have a dead cell
phone. I need to figure out a way. Oh, by the way, the t-shirt I'm wearing is designed by Rob Dobby from fullbleed.org.
Also helped Harry Potter out when he was in a fix.
Also this one, yeah. Oh, wait, who? Oh, no, not Dobby. God dang it.
Yeah, Brian just had to give him a sock, and, the shirts just started appearing.
Brian gave him a sock, Dobby gave him a bunch of shirts. That's how elf magic works.
Exactly. Dobby gives Brian shirts. All the shirts Brian wants.
This is awesome, because, again, this is another one that, like,
yeah,
it's one
cool.
thing. It's one thing to know it. It's, like, that looks so good it looks fake to me, right? But it totally works. Natural disaster in U.S. history. Nishcom just lost it in the chat for it. Hurricane of 1900,
or the Johnstown. I don't remember the answer here. I think it was Jonestown. Oh, Johnstown.
It was Galveston. I knew this one even as I was reading that, because that was the best part. Is I'm reading the script, and it's like, and I'm like, growing up in Texas, you hear about it. all the time. That's why they built the Galveston seawall, yeah. because everybody died.
Days of being virtually cut off from society. That was actually all those cans and everything. That looks like our condo.
That's pretty close. This shot.
There are more Jamesons.
Oh, God.
Tell them about that. That was an accident.
Well, it was a happy coincidence. When we wanted to get a shot of a steak, and it's like, I turn it over, and I'm like, I physically gagged, and then the next words out of my mouth were like, Doug, get a close up.
Doug, come here.
So had you left it out on purpose or something?
No, that was not an intentional setup thing. We had food that was within a day that had started to spoil, and it was like, and what's funny is it looked okay from the top, and then we flipped it over. And at first I'm like what's this?
It's like that scene in Poltergeist.
Oh my God, that scene was horrifying. I thought at first that it was like congealed fat, because you know how like a tasty steak will marbleize.
Fat always.
And I turned it over, and then it just started, you know, doing the worm, so to speak.
That was unplanned.
And it was horrifying. Yeah.
And so Brian got a straw.
But that had been food left out on purpose to look like it had been left out, or
no? Well, no. I mean, this is the object lesson in how easy it is to have food spoil on you without you realizing it. Like it was a cooked steak. We had been shooting stuff at one thing, and then the next day it's like, oh, let's get that steak, and then turns out to have been horrifically spoiled, which is why you have to preserve all your foods in there.
Yeah, it's my dad was a food scientist, and he was educating the public on how to avoid such
scenarios. Yes, exactly. Well, that's oh my God, it was amazing. You're gonna love the back
seat pocket. It's not like I'm gonna get a minivan. Life can surprise you, so can
an auto. That's real life Bonnie moment there on that ad.
You had a hell of a time with the lines on this episode, right?
Well, all of them in general. Well, because what's important is, again, this is what is great for the public about Nat Geo, but was a personal obstacle I had to learn to overcome, which is you have to say factually accurate things. Nat Geo, as I understand it, everything on Nat Geo has to be backed by the full faith of the National Royal Geographic Society, right? Which means
I don't know if you guys have seen Night Attack. We're not real big on facts.
No, we have to go the other way.
We're science.
If the National Geographic Society says it, we just lie about it the other way. So this is a big change for Brian to actually go along with,
There's an add-on. Guys, look, there's an ad.
New episode's Monday.
Save thousands on your next purchase. That was way too easy.
There's a big war on between Night Attack and Nat Geo.
Okay, let's not even joke that way. Oh, for credibility? Like, who's the more credible?
I'm not going to say who won. But I think you can draw your own conclusions. What the shit is going on here?
I don't know.
I've not heard of the show. All right.
Man, you do just look so much classier when, like, the Nat Geo logo appears after you on TV, right? Like... You just like that is like that's a good logo to have follow your face.
Midzula asks if they let me keep the jet. They did not. Oh, I guess that means we can say kind of a little spoilers.
Oh
that,
yeah.
There were little segments that you saw in the ad.
The Porsche.
Porsche was an amazing moment.
Yeah.
What else? Oh my God, I'm looking at a cobra. Sorry, I'm enchanted by the other fine programming.
Booze.
I was like, I gotta have to DVR that.
What is this? No, this is not us. Okay, we didn't do that. Ben Franklin was not with us at all.
So, man, I guess we're coming up on the end. This is the other thing I can't believe about the show. It moves so quickly.
It's almost over.
Yeah.
There's unfortunately no hack that we were able to find where you could get on Xbox Live in case of an apocalypse.
Yeah. That really which is all you want. Oh, this is, yes, yes. I forgot all about that.
That was not us.
No, we did not actually summon the civilian police. This is awesome. Because these are, as I understand it, and because I'm not currently on Nat Geo, I could be totally wrong about this, and it's okay. These are made with these are made by people protesting, you know, who are gonna have tear gas thrown at them.
This is one of my favorite hacks that we did in the entire series. I thought this one was really cool. I know it was like terribly uncomfortable, right?
No. This is well. I got so interested in this because we had activated charcoal powder, but you know you could find it in the. Or I think I mentioned in there that you could get it.
Yeah. Like the water filtration in your fish tank, your medicine cabinet, or even in your odor protecting insoles.
Yeah. So it's basically it's just activated charcoal powder and a soda can, and then you strap a 2-liter bottle to your face, and. And again, you know, it's like we can't possibly say that this will protect you if you're in the middle of a riot or whatever. But
if you're going to riot.
But I'm just saying all the cool rioters are wearing these over their face.
All the cool rioters put a squirt
brand of soda bottle.
Hey, listen, man, I live in Oakland. I might have to wear this to the park, like just for, you know, just to be on the safe side. Toothpaste or lemons?
The answer is. You have a guess? You have a guess?
Equal parts antacid with water and spraying it in your eyes. Toothpaste underneath them, or even breathing through a lemon-soaked rag will all help to neutralize tear gas solution and reduce any eye or breathing irritation. When the situation gets desperate enough,
they're mad because we pulled the all three trick. They're all like, "You jerk!" People will take phone books
and tiles. You're all wrong. Cover the whole thing
in duct tape. Wrong.
Can we talk about the original plan for the body armor?
Oh my gosh!
Can we talk about that?
Wait, what have we talked about? What was the? Oh, geez. Well, oh no. Okay. When you start writing some things, sometimes you have some wacky brainstorms, and one of our brainstorms involved actually shooting in a bulletproof vest.
This wasn't something.
This one I did not believe worked.
Yeah.
Wife Vito. No,
it wasn't even one of the ones that we came up with.
Yes. No. It was just suggesting to take all this stuff and go
yeah.
out to the street.
Yeah. This is like, oh, you're gonna make your own body armor, and Jason's gonna wear the body armor, and Brian's gonna shoot Jason. And Matt Geo was like, no.
So what's funny is we shot these out of order, and that scene right there, while I'm walking down the street looking like the Road Warrior, the badass Jimmy Fay was like, hey man, why don't you just turn and like, you know, aim it right at the camera, right at me? I was like, well, I don't know, I think this would be real dangerous to do. He's like, yeah, look great, just don't let go. And so we did it, and sure enough, it did look great. And then we shot that scene where I did, and we shot a few takes at it, and one of the times it pierced right through the metal of that corrugated that metal in the background.
Oh,
it went right through it. And then all of a sudden there's this moment I look over at Jimmy Fay and we're just like, wow. You're like, that was really daring of us.
All right, so here's another super cut that I want someone to put together is just all of the Jason, like, what faces? Like, just all of the...
Yeah, that was very uncomfortable. That sucked.
Yeah. Well, and it's funny because there's...
Oh, great!
There's that... There's that... That's Brian's lemon face right there. You're like,
God, that's getting memed to hell.
Well,
15 minutes.
Do you remember, like we fire, and there was that shocking, like, it felt like an eternity of 2 seconds. And you're like, oh, I guess it doesn't work.
Oh, my God. It's like Satan peed in my eyes.
Mix the two together over heat, and for a container...
Mitsula says we have to make those faces our Twitter avatars.
Thank you, that's Doug, Kevin, and Jimmy for getting those in super slow motion with the F700.
Oh my god. Yeah, I was surprised at how much of that you get out of it. You can find, by the way, there's a great tutorial on making these. If you go to the King of Random, Grant Thompson is another one of the, he does fantastic life hacking videos. And in fact, in this case, I called him on the specifics of his recipe for that, and he was very, very cool about it. So definitely follow him over on YouTube. 600 million seems ridiculous.
So if you haven't hashtagged hacking the system,
yeah, man,
that would be a good time. Everyone!
One more time! You might
have to improvise. Oh, yeah, this one's cool. This is some battlefield savvy.
I definitely have done that, by the way. A couple of I duct taped my wife's leg together.
What?
Yeah, do you have your scar? You can share your scar. But in a
severe situation, she says, yes, I still have a scar.
See, it fades. In my case, we were tubing down the Guadalupe River, and I got out of the tube and stepped. Just there happened to be a small rock that was really jagged, and it just poked just a full-on hole right in my foot. Mm. And I went to the nearest neighbor. And, oh, man, I ate that full can of beans. I ate so many. I ate lukewarm beans. But I went up, and I was like, hey, I appear to have a giant hole in my foot. Can I help? And these poor people who live there, I mean, they get drunken party goers at all hours. And so they're like, please don't walk on our land. And I was like, that's fine, but I still have 2 hours, and this is an open wound, and they're all like, I will bring you some duct tape. And so I just sealed it up and then went the rest of the way. Holy cow, that's it, man.
It's over?
Yeah.
I wasn't
man,
even...
That's all the system that was meant to be hacked tonight.
Tonight?
I was looking the other way, and then it ended.
I'll tell you what's this new trend that is happening of TV shows that just get straight to the point. Of like quit screwing around where it's like, all right, that one's over. Next show, go. I love it.
All right, Brian Jason, shut up.
Congratulations, guys. That was an awesome premiere. Well, everybody, let's go ahead and get a round of applause. Get one last good round of hashtag hacking the system out there. Make sure that everybody knows that this shit was super live. And also, if you were watching this stream from the Pacific time zone, then you have... 2 more hours when you watch it in glorious HD.
Syncing that back up if you like. Really appreciate it. Thanks for both you guys joining. What was it like? Was this the first time you'd gotten to see any of this, Tom?
Well, no. I saw your first two that aired,
previously. Right.
Yeah, the pilots shot. But I hadn't seen any of the new stuff other than the steel wool bit that I'd seen online.
Yeah, Tom's like, I was playing Destiny, so yeah, whatever.
I wasn't really aware that you were even on right now.
So when does it start?
Yeah.
This is great, and I feel the same way about these as I did to the first two, which is so on point, excellent information, well conveyed, fun to watch. Guys are kicking ass, man.
Dude, well, thank you.
I'm the year of search and rescue, so that second episode, I was familiar with a lot of that stuff, and it's for real.
Wait, you did a year of search and rescue?
Yeah, I did.
I thought you worked at Half Price, Tom.
Yeah. Next thing you know, you'll be telling me you wrote books and that you host shows about technology, too.
So I was back in Alameda County when I was working at CNET. I volunteered for you.
Right on. Well, thanks to everyone who showed up. I hope you guys continue to tune in. We'll do these every Monday.
On Friday.
That's right. I saw that. Yeah. By the way, if anyone wants to call in, we'll keep the lines open. We'll stay on for about 20 more minutes. Oh, I forgot to call my mom. Doggone it. And my mom just tweeted saying, fabulous, hacking the system. Loved it. I was like, sorry, Mom.
That's
I meant
fantastic.
To call you earlier today. But night is tech show.
The next lines episodes.
It's every Tuesday, as I understand it, and of course, I'm sorry, yes, every Tuesday is Night Attack. Everything's subject to change, but last I heard is that, we're going to do 2 episodes per Monday for at least the next couple of of Mondays.
And then do you know what's next Monday, though?
Towards the end of it, there's going to be like one episode on Monday.
Yeah, then they're going to start teasing you. Yeah. It's like now they're like, now you got to start paying.
I guess I was thinking, what are some of the other topics that we can look forward to?
I think it's all out on the DVR, right? So we can talk about it.
It's out.
The travel episode I thought was fantastic because so much of the travel episode I definitely know because I only spent 14 years touring the United States with the stage show, and you pick up a few tricks on travel. Have you seen that one, Justin? Did I get
the list? The only one that I had seen previously was the first one, the copy doctor one.
Okay.
That was rough edited at the point that I was visiting you guys out in California.
Awesome. Hold on. We got somebody calling right now. James is on the line. What's up, James?
Hey, man. I just wanted to call in and say, awesome show. That was really, really wicked.
That's great.
I'm sitting here. My wife was in the other room. She's like, I'm going to bed, blah, blah, blah. I said, fine, whatever. I said, there's this guy that I follow on the internet and blah, blah, blah. And I said, I got to watch it. They're having a watch party. She's like, really? She walks over. She looks at it. She's like, that actually looks cool. DVR it and I'll watch it later. I'm like, okay.
Well, that's great. Well, good, man.
So, no, good. This is excellent production, guys. I mean, it looks really good. And the knowledge base. I hope you guys get picked up for at least two more seasons.
Oh,
awesome
dude,
stuff.
Yeah. But after that, stop.
Not three.
Well, we don't want to break any trends.
Seriously,
here.
You must stop. Our penalties will be created and enforced. All right. Thanks, James. Appreciate it.
Six seasons in a movie.
Dude, I want to hack the system of the movie. And I want it to take long enough that we're creeping up on 60. And the whole movie is just us like, what about this one? And you're like, get bent, asshole.
Yeah. Here's the way you can win at bingo.
You could use your colostomy bag to hide chips. All
right.
This is your mother.
Travel.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hold on. I got both Justin and Ryan talking at the same time. Ryan was pretending to be my mom. What did you want to say as my mom?
This is your mother. And I would just like to say that the show was pretty good.
Man, mom, I don't think
sound like Mickey at all.
I don't think I ever realized how much like Bill Cosby you sound.
Yeah, really.
I don't do no zoomity bop. But Bill, I love you, Brian.
Is this Bill Cosby pretending to be my mom again?
No, this is your mother, Brian.
I think it's Ryan pretending to be your mom, pretending to be Bill Cosby.
Okay, all right. Hanging up on there. All right, so we got the travel
it's
one.
It's amazing when you can be accidentally anti-Semitic. Like, that's really like the best kind.
So we, the outdoors, hacking the great outdoors, I thought was a really good one.
What I was trying to say before Bill Cosby called in was it's hacking crime and hacking travel next week.
Or next week. Okay, dude, those are both really, really good. And we have a restaurants episode.
The hacking the outdoors, that was the sweatiest episode.
Oh, geez. Is it weird that I had this mad urge to run downstairs, grab the shirt I wore on that episode, and just show off how filthy it was?
Why haven't you washed it?
I don't know why. It's been washed.
Oh, it's been washed.
But it's like I have a nostalgic attachment to it. I don't want to throw it away because...
Oh, it's so gross.
Captain Monk wants to know if we're going to do a viewing party next week. Absolutely, absolutely, yes. That's definitely going to happen.
Every Monday.
Man, I guess that's it. Hold on, we got one thing that somebody keeps posting. Oh, wait, hang on, we got a caller. Jackie, you're on the line.
Hey, I just want to say I am so proud. I was grinning from ear to ear. And
that is
I want to
awesome.
Know... Do you have any kind of reaction photos of your daughters watching this?
Oh! Yeah, well, I mean, they had seen bits and pieces of it, but it's weird because, like, you want your children to respect you but not necessarily be fans of you. You're like, I don't want to sell you, like, hey, man, isn't Dad rad? Look at him playing with fire and making weapons.
Saying, hashtag cool dad.
You're like, big time your kids next time. Like, you're just going to be like, excuse me, do you know who Dad is? Go to sleep.
It's like we went to laser tag today. I'm like, yeah, you may have gotten a high score, but guess who's got a TV show on Nat Geo?
You're going to go downstairs for the autograph signing now?
That's right.
You have to go to bed because I'm on National Geographic.
All right, Jaime's on the line. What's up, bud?
Hey guys. Ryan, the first thing I want to tell you is it's, you know, congratulations. This is awesome. Also, when will it show in my country? Because, you know, they're showing some other thing on Nat Geo.
What you need to do is call your cable company and harass them. Like,
say, okay. I want my MTV.
That's right.
All right. Okay.
They'll figure it out. It's an inside joke.
Either that, or just move to Austin. Those are your only two choices.
Oh. Don't do the latter.
Those are my two choices. All right. I'll do one of those.
All right. Bye. We've got Bryce on the line. What's up, Bryce?
Bryce.
Hey, can you hear us?
Yeah. I hear someone. Wait.
We don't hear you.
Oh, wait. No. We got a whole room of people. You guys were doing a viewing party during our viewing party.
Oh, shit. we'll talk. We're having a little party for our new favorite show, Brain Games. No, good shows. They were awesome, man.
A little table flip, like, yeah. Ah!
So we just wanted to call in and say awesome show,
dude. Appreciate it, man.
Everybody here had a great time watching it.
Sweet,
and,
man.
Still can't hear you. All right, I think it's because we have Bluetooth fucking hooked up and it's not right. So,
yeah, screw Bluetooth.
We're gonna get off.
All right. Bye, dude. Thanks. Oh, dude, that's fantastic.
Brian, how do you feel, man? That was this is a big moment, man. Take me inside the mind of Brian Brushwood.
I don't know, man. It's so funny because, like, if I was any kind of smart, wait. There's only one opinion I care about. Come over here, little girl. Come here. Yeah, just come talk on the microphone. Tell me what you thought. Did you watch the show? Yeah. Well, you got to talk onto the microphone. Get over here, silly. There we go. Wait. What's your name?
Josie.
And what do you do? Wait, what did you think of the show?
Good.
What was your favorite part?
When you put on all the stuff and you look really cool, you put on the
alien. Josie, come on, you're a professional.
when I put on all the stuff and I looked really cool?
Yeah.
With the bow and arrow?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you want to dress up like that and walk down the street? No. Okay.
Josie, do you want to shoot the bow and arrow?
All right.
It runs in the family.
All right, here get out of here. Good night, sweetheart.
Night, Josie.
Night, Josie.
Oh, there was something we were just talking about. Oh, you were asking. Oh, I said
come on, man, bring me inside the mind of Brian Brushwood. We've talked a lot. You had three big milestones coming up. You were going to pass a million subs on Scam School on YouTube. You're turning 40 years old. Yep. You had your first nationally televised series debut. Now the third of those has happened. Bring me inside the mind of Brian.
What's funny is all I can, I guess you know the live wire act that we do whenever we go live streaming. It's like, to me, I'm just so happy that I was able to come in and on top of everything, just as a cherry on top, you know, have both of us do a juggling act for everyone live to you know, add the sauce on top. Kevin Smith talked about how when he first entered the festival circuit with Clerks, you know, they would tour with their movie and then they would get on stage afterwards and they would talk. And you know, he would try to be funny and entertaining. And, you know, in my mind, all he was trying to do is just serve to the best of his ability. But on the way out of one of those movies, he overheard someone say to the person next to him, like, hey, what'd you think of the movie? And the guy goes, I don't know, the movie was shit, but those guys were pretty funny. And all of a sudden he realized that he could move the needle. He could affect after the fact people's opinions of you know, his work and his ability to provide for them beyond, you know, the product itself did not have to stand on its own. And I absolutely adored that. And I'm just, to be honest, like, everything in my mind is electrified right now. And I'm just so thrilled. More important than that it's out and that it's something that I'm proud of, and I'm proud of all the hardworking people who made that stuff happen. I know, you know, Paul told us that he was watching, and you know, Alex did amazing. I need to write down, I need to have all the names in front of me so I could properly thank everyone. We'll do that later on. But In this moment,
you're about to get played off by the orchestra.
That's fine. In this moment, the only thing I care about is the fact that I was able to be here with all of these guys, the chat room, you know, being so supremely patient the entire time with what was a very taxing and difficult schedule. CJ Johnson's calling me on the phone. I don't know if I can get him on there. Oh, there we go. CJ, you're on the live stream. What's up, buddy?
Well, I don't have TV, but I listen to you guys talk about it. It sounds like a good
show. So how was it? Did it sound like an interesting show?
Yeah, it sounds great. I can't wait to get it. I had a couple people DVR it, and I'll go over to their place and watch it. But yeah, it sounds good, and you look happy about it. And
I'm absolutely thrilled. Awesome. Well, CJ, you're the best, and high fives to everyone.
Well, it sounds like you guys knocked it out of the park. Congrats.
All right, thanks, bud. What about you, man? Where's your head at? Because you came home and like you didn't bug me on anything. You weren't haranguing, and I was like,
I
couldn't.
What did
you want me to say? No. I couldn't.
Like after it was all done?
Yes, yes. After we shot and we're waiting everything. Wait, what?
Oh yeah. Allison is like, I'm more excited than he is.
I guess that's one of the weird things is you're so chill about it, man.
Well, you know, honestly, I did an interview with TV Dudes, thetvdudes.com, the other day. And one of the questions they asked me was like, how are you feeling? Are you excited and all that? And I said, I'm really feeling kind of talking heads. This is not my beautiful house. Like water flowing underground. You know, it's just like, how did I get here? It's really just like, okay, this is happening.
It only became real when I saw a commercial for it. I don't know.
Like an hour ago? you know, really, that had more of an impact on me, the commercial, mm-hmm. than seeing the actual show. But it's weird because it kind of snuck up on me, you know?
Yes.
And I mean, we had this like long period where we were working and everything, and then a long wait period while the editing team and everything was kicking ass on what's that?
Oh my gosh! Yeah,
the long prep period of writing and researching and all that.
It was almost a year of writing that went into everything, literally years of research. Where it's like, you know, Jason and I, long before the series was ever picked up, we had this dumping file of just ideas that might turn into things down the road. And again, if I have failed, it's if there's one thing I'm really disappointed about tonight, it's that I didn't think to have a giant list of everyone to thank. I mean, they're in the credits. I guess you could read the credits.
Yeah, but, all of those people.
But in all sincerity, they were so patient to take a couple of noobs who grew up in the minor leagues of the internet, where it's the Wild West and anything goes, and we don't have to be prepared or whatever, to this highly regimented, a world of television. They were extraordinarily patient with us, and I'm hoping there's a second season where we get to act more professional.
We had a great crew. I mean, we had a lot of, you know, it was stressful at times because, you know, we were shooting a TV show. It's not all cake and butterflies.
Cake and butterflies.
Only cake. Funny enough, butterflies aren't allowed in Los Angeles, so you know you gotta do without.
It's not all Porsches and apple juice, as Allison said.
Hey, Brian, man, I gotta take off.
Yeah. You know what? Let's go ahead and wind everything down. I don't wanna blow all of our steam just on this first night. I mean, we're excited here. We'll do this every week. What I'd love to do is spend the entire hour with some of the folks in production. If any of those guys want to call in and be on the live stream.
Yeah,
with us.
Where are you guys? Come on,
come on, Slacker. I can't even say that with a straight face. Oh, we did the How to Win at Anything episode, like basically how to win pretty much every game out there.
Oh yeah,
and bunch of other stuff. We'll talk about all that stuff.
That's something that I might actually be in the background of.
Oh shoot, that's right. At some point, you showed up. I'm gonna save it. I'm gonna save it for future episodes.
There's a lot of funny stories. Wait, let me just say this.
Yep.
It is awesome like to be here with you guys for this show. This is an awesome.
Thanks for coming,
awesome
guys.
Show. I know how much it took out of you guys to do it and to put all your effort and you know uproot your entire existences and roll out to LA for that period of time. It's a major accomplishment and everybody should be really excited. Make sure again hashtag hacking the system at Nat Geo channel.
At Nat Geo channel is if you want to tell them what you thought of the show. Hopefully you'll say nice things. We're really excited. Thank you guys for being there and stick around for the West Coast feed as well. Who's that? DC till we DIE. Bye, guys.